these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Paul and Barnabas had proclaimed the good news to that city and made a considerable number of disciples, they returned to Lystra and to Iconium and to Antioch. They strengthened the spirits of the disciples and exhorted them to persevere in the faith, saying, "It is necessary for us to undergo many hardships to enter the kingdom of God." They appointed elders for them in each church, and with prayer and fasting, commended them to the Lord, in whom they had put their faith. Then they traveled through Pisidia and reached Pamphylia. After proclaiming the word at Persia, they went down to Attalia. From there they sailed to Antioch, where they had been commended to the grace of God for the work they had now accomplished. And when they arrived, they called the church together heard of what God had done with them and how he had opened the door of faith to the Gentiles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away.
Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Judas had left them, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and God will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little while longer. I give you a new commandment, love one another. As I have loved you, so you also should love one another. This is how all will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Gospel for this fifth weekend of Easter comes from John chapter 13, verses 31 to 35, a relatively short gospel. During the Easter season, a majority of our gospels come from the Gospel of St. John. And John has arranged his gospel in a very precise and very particular way, right? According to the Holy Spirit's design. There are 21 chapters in the Gospel of St. John. The first part, the first 12 chapters, is called the Book of Signs, right? That's because, right, there are a number of signs that are performed by Jesus that begin to reveal his identity as the Son of God. And the second part of John's Gospel is called the Book of Glory. So in the Book of Signs, the Book of Glory. And it consists of this Book of Glory in a long narrative of the Last Supper, then it's followed by the Passion narrative, and then it's about the Lord's resurrection, various encounters of the Lord's resurrection. This all constitutes the Book of Glory. Well, glory, for John, is a way of talking about the revelation of God in the very person of Jesus Christ. He is the glory. He is the glory of God. So today's gospel and the gospel of the next couple of Sundays will come from this particular part, this Book of Glory from John's gospel. This chapter today is from the Last Supper narrative, but it's also referred to as the Farewell Discourse. The Farewell Discourse. These chapters, these verses of St. John's Gospel are considered some of the most precious and intimate lines in the New Testament. Very precious. We're taking some time just to go through those chapters, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 of the Gospel of John. It's very precious, very intimate part of the New Testament. According to John, all this is written that we may come to believe, that we would come to believe in Jesus, the uniqueness of Jesus Christ, who he is, and believe not merely in an intellectual way, but with our hearts. Merely intellectual belief entails perhaps an agreement with what you believe in, but it has very little impact on the way that you live your life day in and day out. But real belief means that, yes, we believe believe in the tenets of our faith, right? But it has a profound influence and it defines who we are each and every day of our lives. So belief in John's gospel is about real faith, real belief. So today's gospel begins with Judas leaving the disciples, right? He goes out into the darkness to betray the Lord, right? Jesus then tells the disciples, "I give you a new commandment, love one another. Just as I have loved you, you must love one another." In these words, Jesus gives a clear summary of what our Christian life is about. This is the summary. A summary statement, right, of what it means to be Christian. Love one another as I have loved you. Right? Jesus calls this a new commandment. In what way is it new, though? You know, right? After all, in the Old Testament, right, if you look at Book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 18, right? It says, "You shall love your neighbor as yourself." So, in some ways, it's old, right? But John uses the word kainos, for new in his gospel. I give you a kainos commandment, a new commandment. Kainos means it's new in its nature, it's new in its sense of being a different kind of love, a depth of love. The key to this newness, this kindness, is the words of Jesus when he says, "Love one another just as I have loved you." just as I have loved you. How has Jesus loved them? How has he loved us to the end? Right? The beginning lines of the 13th chapter of the Gospel of John says, he loved them, he loved his own, he loved them to the end. So recall another passage from John 15, 13. No one has greater love than this, than to lay down one's life for one's friends. This is entirely new. And it's the basis for the new commandment to love one another. We have to think about it in the context that it was given, that this was written, right? This happened in Christ, right? The dominant pagan culture at that time of Jesus, the gods, right? They pay little attention to the things down below. They have a very, very, very little desire about things that are below, right? The fact that God, our God, so loved us in our world would puzzle a traditional pagan of that particular time. So this reality that God loves us and we can love as he loves, as God loves, right, is entirely new. This is a new revelation. Again, Romans thought the gods might come to their aid, right? But they did not believe that the gods loved them. They didn't believe that. The Roman gods, they didn't love them, right? So the Romans consequently feared the gods. They envied the gods. They admired the gods. But they did not love their gods, right? So our scriptures, on the other hand, brothers and sisters, reveal a God who loves us and invites us and challenges you to love as he loves, right, to the end, with all of ourselves. So how did a tiny, obscure, messianic movement, such as the one that we belong to, Christianity, right, that was at the edge of the Roman Empire, replace classical paganism, right, and become the dominant faith of Western civilization and well beyond, right? Obviously, there could be many answers, many, many answers that are given to this question, but the heart of the answer is given in today's gospel, the new commandment, that Christians up and down history have lived this new commandment, love one another, and that has made the difference in our faith. And if our faith is to continue to live on and grow today, it will be because our faith is lived out in loving each other. Let us stand now, proudly profess our faith. I believe in one God, Almighty,
Maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who show their love
love, let our charity build in New Jerusalem. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and William our Bishop, and all the clergy, religious, and your entire people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us pray.
Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now, before we go,
you probably know, the sunset run following this, people with their numbers on already, people with their shirts on already, this is great. Come on out if you can to participate in the fun, the food, the fellowship, and especially the music. Father John's going to be playing some music this evening. You don't want to miss that if you can participate. So I'm looking forward to running. I'm going to run this, actually. Change really quick after the mass and do the run. So anyway, next weekend as well, you don't want to miss this. We're going to have a French toast breakfast sponsored by our Knights of Columbus, 007s, next Sunday, May 22nd, after the 8 o'clock and the 10 o'clock mass. So French toast breakfast, looking forward to that. And check your bulletins, please. We are looking for vacation Bible school volunteers. It's really, really, really important to do that. Okay, we're looking for vacation Bible school volunteers. VBS will be held this year, July 11th through the July 15th. If you're interested, please contact Alejandro Duda in our office, or contact information is also in the bulletin. Okay. And collection baskets are every door for your contribution. We're so very grateful for each week your support of this wonderful parish. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, your families, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.